Running in over 60 metro areas around the world on Microsoft's Global Edge Network, Azure Front Door Service is a highly available and scalable web application acceleration platform. Sharad Agrawal is here to show us how Front Door enables you to make your global applications faster, highly available, and scalable. Today on Azure Friday. Today on Azure Friday, we're going to learn all about Azure Front Door Service. And with me is Sharad Agrawal, who is a PM for Azure Front Door. Talk to us about what we're going to learn about today with Front Door.
So Front Door is a global web application acceleration platform, and it helps you make your service really scalable, make it much, much more available. It increases your application's reliability, and all of this while giving you a lot of performance boost. We also take care of security, application layer security. So I'm going to talk about it in a while.
Well, why don't you walk us through what this is?
Sure. Okay. So in a typical case, what happens, how do you really connect with your application to the to your users to your application backends? If you're not using a content delivery network or an application delivery network, what happens is your users travel from their location to your regional deployments, and then all that happens over the long open internet, which is not very reliable. Somebody, some ISP in the middle can play around with your routing announcements and things like that, right, and you get a lot of network errors. It's not really reliable. So what happens is when you introduce a content delivery network or an application delivery network, so the POPs or the points of presences for these CDNs or these application delivery networks, they help you connect the end user connection very close to them. And then they maintain long haul connections to your application backend. So you're able to connect, make those SSL handshakes very close to your end users, and then correspondingly from there to the backend again, because these are all warm connections getting reused, you get a performance boost there as well. You may feel like there's a hop getting added, but it still gives you performance benefit overall. So what does Azure Front Door Service bring to the table? Well, we use our global network. It's a dedicated private network of Microsoft. We are actually very proud and we boast about it quite a lot. So from the Edge POP to your application backend, it goes over Microsoft global network. So there is much, much more higher network reliability that you get. Even if your application is not hosted on Azure, we still route it to the nearest point where your application is and then exit from that location. So you sort of get a dedicated network for your end users, and so it just boosts your network performance and reliability.
Okay.
Okay, so what more about Azure Front Door? So Azure Front Door is, let me begin with the last portion, which is we've been there for quite a good amount of time. We've been there in the industry internally for over 5 years now, and we've been dealing with some of the biggest Microsoft's web workloads.
So this is nothing new. We've been doing this with our own properties, with our own services for, you say, 5 years.
Absolutely.
Or more.
Yep. So we started with Bing, to be honest. And then we've slowly added all these different workloads, both on the consumer side, on the enterprise application side. And so all of these are, in fact, right now running on Azure Front Door. It's just that we are not exposing this capability commercially.
Right. And so now any customer can come along and take advantage of this as a service.
Right.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. And would there be any kind of scale limit? I mean, what is the scale capability of the service?
So as I explained, the kind of applications you see at the bottom, the logos that we have put, these run into, if you add these up, they run into multi-million requests per second globally. And so there's not a limit that we have found as such. We can do massive SSL offloads for applications. And people have been asking me, how much SSL offload, is there a limit to it? I wouldn't say there's a limit to it. Not that we have found very easily thus far. So we provide application acceleration from the Microsoft's Edge. We have built a very seamless experience integrating with app services, with cloud services, with storage. We'll be continuously adding more such integrations. We are a global HTTP, HTTPS load balancing. So we only do HTTP and HTTPS workloads, and then we provide instant multi-region or global failover. So if your application instances are running, I'll actually show a demo also on that. If they're running in two regions, if one of them goes down, we'll fail over as soon as we detect that particular instance has gone down.
What if I want to deploy this to a specific area, a specific geography?
Oh, that's a good question. So Azure Front Door Service is a global platform. So as soon as you create a front door instance, we deploy your configuration across all of our POPs globally. So okay. You don't have to just do, okay, I want to deploy just in central US or in particular region, say India. It just gets deployed to all the locations wherever our POPs are.
And on the other side, what if I don't want it deployed to certain areas or certain regions?
Yeah, so the questions that we get regarding that usually is, okay, I want to filter traffic for a particular user.
Right.
And it can go both ways. People ask, okay, I want to only allow traffic from users of these countries, right, or I want to block traffic from XYZ countries. So if you have the capability to enable geo-filtering, you can allow or block certain countries for your traffic, for your web workloads.
Great. Yeah. Do you have something to show us? Let's see this.
Sure, absolutely.
Okay.
So here I have an instance. So I'll just showcase how the creation workflow is. So in this, I'm just creating a particular resource group, say short test here, and moving on. So what you need to do is first provision a front end host. Basically, this is your front end from front door where your mm-hmm. application will hit. Let's call it Friday demo, not Friday. Okay, and I go and add. Then the next thing you need to do is you need to add backend pool. So what you've done is there are three high-level concepts. There's a front-end host, then there are backend pools, and then you have routing rules that connect these front-end hosts to the backend pools. So let me name this just test for now. I go ahead and add a backend pool. Let me pick something that I already have. Let me add another instance. And let me pick another. Okay, so I've added two backends here. I'm just explaining how this workflow is. So you can control how the health probes, et cetera, function for your particular backend pool. Where do we need to send the health probes? How often do we need to send the health probes? You can define how many sample set you need for the health probes to be counted as success, evaluated, and okay. then how many you need for it to be successful.
Okay.
This zero is more like send it to the fastest available backend.
Okay.
Yeah. You can increase the threshold your latency sensitivity so that you can round robin across multiple ones if you want to. But if you are very latency sensitive, just set it to zero. It'll always pick the fastest backend where you need to send the traffic to. So I've added the backend tool now, and I'll just go ahead and create a routing rule. So it just automatically picks up the values. It's just saying that for this particular front-end host, which is fridaydemo.azurev.net, anything underneath, just send it to this particular, the backend pool that I just created. It'll automatically pick one of the backends which are up and running.
Okay.
And the one which is fastest, the closest to you. You can additionally also go and enable other advanced features like caching. You can do static asset caching and stuff. But for now, let me just go ahead and create it. So as you can see, it's actually pretty simple and straightforward.
Yeah, it just walks you right through it.
Yeah, it's very simple, straightforward.
Okay.
So in the interest of time, what I'll do is I'll just pick an existing instance that I've created. So I have two websites that I've created here. So one of them is in central US. This is a web this is an Azure website. And there's another one which is in North Europe that I've created.
Okay.
So this is the one in central US. And this is the instance that I have in North Europe. What I'm going to do is now showcase what Front Door is, how Front Door is set up. So I've created Azure Friday demo.azurefd.net. Mm-hmm. I've added both these instances, if you see. This is the central US one, and the other one is for North Europe that I've added here. And I can simply open the routing rule that connects them. So it just connects it. Okay, anything coming to azfridaydemo.azurefd.net goes to that particular backend pool, as I explained. So let me just refresh this. So you can see it's going to central US. What it's showing is because I'm right now in Seattle area, this is picking up the closest node that is there, and it's automatically going to central US. It's not going to North Europe instance, for example.
Right.
The previous screen you saw was from a failover scenario that I had. Now, let me do a quick test side by side, okay? So I have, what I'm trying to do here is on the left-hand side, I'm trying to go to the Azure Front Door instance. And on the right-hand side, I'm hitting the database, the app service instance directly. So you'll see that I'm actually going to the central US instance here, versus on the left-hand side, I'm actually going to the Azure Friday demo instance that I just created for Azure Front Door. What it's also doing is it's actually going and pulling a 100KB object. It's it's an image file, and there is no caching whatsoever. So it's just pulling it every time it's creating a connection. Okay. So let me just start this. I'm going to give advantage to the app service, hitting it directly, and then I'm going to start the other one. So it's just querying the object again and again and again. You'll start to see the difference slowly picking up as connections getting warmed up and getting reused.
You can definitely see some performance improvements going through Front Door.
Yeah. So you'll see how much lag you're getting. And I'm not playing around. And in fact, to be honest, we are actually on the Microsoft's corporate network right now. Mm-hmm. So that the proxies, et cetera, internally also play a role in that, but it becomes even better in some other game when you're actually in the open internet and trying a normal end user is trying it out. Okay, so now let me go to the next part of the demo here. We talked about instant global failover scenarios, right? So what I'm going to do is for my test central, central US instance, I had actually set the health probe to test this file test.html. I can actually show that to you. So yeah, so if this is still working. And I'm going to just nuke it. So what I'll just a simple test will be that to fail the health probes will be just I'll just rename the file and go here. By the way, this is a cool feature that App Service has built. I can make inline changes and deploy and just immediately deploys. And I check this in. So as soon as I check this in, the App Service instance will get automatically updated. So you can see the health probes have started failing.
Right.
Now, what is effectively happening right now is that we have set some health probe frequency, as I mentioned. So AFD is looking for those number of samples. So if as soon as we have the enough number of samples to say that, okay, now the backend is down, I need to fail over, we will start failing over instantaneously the moment we detect that happening. We have enough samples at hand. So here's my instance, which was, it'll still go to central US because I've just failed the health probe. The site is still up and running at that particular default site. But in a few seconds, you will notice that it's actually failing over to the North Europe instance. Give it a few seconds. Yep.
There we go.
So now it'll consistently keep going to the North Europe instance. Okay, so that's the immediate failover scenario that I was talking about.
Great, and that was pretty easy to set up. So an easy setup, you immediately get some higher performance, higher performance, almost half the time.
Yeah.
And you get failover and high availability, more highly available applications.
And even when the high availability is getting showcased and there's an instant global failover, because we're maintaining these warm connections, et cetera, because there are multiple users that are actually connecting to Front Door, your failover would happen with minimum to no latency impact as such. We'll just be pulling it from the North Europe instance in this particular case. But then because of Microsoft's global network, it'll still be a lot faster than hitting it directly.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for coming in and talking to us about Azure Front Door. It's going to be great to see this go into public preview and customers be able to sign up and take advantage of this.
Yes.
So already available in public preview starting?
So it's going into public preview on Monday, the 24th of September.
Okay.
We're launching it at Ignite for the first time.
Very good.
That, you can actually go to the link azure.com/frontdoor, read more about it, and you'll have a link to just getting started from there itself.
Great. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much, Lara.
I look forward to learning more about this and using the service.
Thanks so much, Lara.
We've been learning all about Azure Front Door today on Azure Friday.